from there. Yeah. Yeah, stay from there. From there, from there. From there. Talk to the hand.
Go around there. Let's go behind it.
Yeah, go behind. Behind. You go behind. You go behind. Not from here, behind, behind.
Don't wanna discuss? We'll go.
Why? By the way, why do I need to discuss?
You challenged us.
Oh, no, I didn't challenge no one.
You have un-Islamic beliefs.
Okay, you are kafir. What did I do to you?
Likewise.
You are, okay, likewise. Oh, kafir, just get lost.
Likewise.
Then get lost, don't come to me. Get lost. Get
lost. Bring us to Islam.
Get lost.
Bring us to Islam.
إنك لا تهدي من أحببت ولكن الله يهدي من يشاء. By the way, don't touch me. If you touch me again, I will hit you.
I came to your shoe.
Yeah, yeah, don't touch me. I'm warning you.
I came to your shoe.
Yeah, don't touch me. Just get lost. Now, you see here, I will tell you something. Those filthy scumbags, the Qadianis. Those Qadianis. The one who follow the filthy scumbag Ghulam Ahmad, the scumbag. That scumbag who pretend to be, and that guy, he was like, you know what he used to do? He made the Muslims in India. He actually spread the Muslim of India. What he did, he said, don't fight the British. Why don't fight the British? Because they are with the British. Because they are their masters. Their masters. Okay, then
they are
kidding. Okay. We have then why do you talk to me? Okay, why do you talk to me? I do.
Speak to me. They are liars.
Uncle. I will tell you. We have someone. No. Who made a prophecy?
They invited us.
We don't deal with scumbags. Not you. Which is not you. You are not included. Because you are not included. True. You are not included. That's true. You are a scumbag. You are just only a filthy scumbag following a filthy scumbag like you. That's who you are. Who you are? You are just only a filthy scumbag following a filthy scumbag like you. Ghulam Ahmad, ulama, you don't use our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are the filthy scumbag of the Qadianis. You follow a false scumbag. That scumbag, what he used to do? Let's talk about Muhammad Begum. Why you don't talk? Why you hide from Muhammad Begum? Why don't you talk about Muhammad Begum? You dog, you come to my shoes. You come to my feet, you dog. You are a dog. You are just only a dog. You come to my shoes, you filthy dog. So that's how it is. So when you see this filthy dog, who comes here and he pretends that he knows what he has, what they have. They have only false prophet. That prophet is come back. What he did? Few things. Firstly, Muhammad Begum, he said, I will marry you. And he didn't marry here. If you don't marry, you're going to die. She didn't die. If you marry someone else, they all outlived him. That shows this comeback. He would pretend to be a prophet. Look at this. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us, will be coming people who are false prophets, scumbags. Musaylam al-Kadhab and Ahmadi and that Ghulam Ahmad, that scumbag and Musaylama. May Allah unite them both in hellfire. Those scumbags, my brothers, we need to understand. Those people, I will tell you something. Even their faith is dying, alhamdulillah. That faith, and I will tell you something. Qadianism is dying. And I will say this because, alhamdulillah, Allah brings people from Qadianism to Islam. And Allah brought this brother and many brothers. Alhamdulillah, we have many converts, many reverts from the Qadianis who become Muslims. And that's why I will say to you, it is like when you call it, when you slaughter an animal, the last kick. This is the last kick of the animal. That's what it is. They do their last kick. And that's what they are. They are doing their last kick because they know their religion is dying. They know they are only following a filthy scumbag. That scumbag, what he did, he spread the... No, they are kuffar. out of the fold of Islam. They are out of the fold of Islam. And even it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Because, but I will tell you something. There are people who believe in the Quran. Musaylim al-Kadhab believed in the Quran. Musaylim al-Kadhab believed in the Quran. Musaylim al-Kadhab believed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be a prophet. And he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, listen, you are a prophet of Allah from Quraysh, and I'm a prophet of Allah from Bani Hanifa. He said this. And he's a scumbag in the hellfire. And he believed in the Quran. So it doesn't matter if someone believes in the Quran. It does not matter if he believes in something opposite to the Quran. Allah Azza wa Jal affirmed in the Quran, وخاتم النبيين. خاتم, the least, the seal, and the last prophet, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You go to heaven by 5 pillars of Islam. Shahadati an la ilaha illallah, wa anna Muhammad rasulullah, wa iqam al-salah, wa ita'i al-zakah, sawm ramadan, wa hajj al-bayt. So firstly, you do the shahada. Meaning when you say Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the final, there is no prophet after him. And as well to establish the prayer. And after that, you do the zakat, the mandatory charity. And you fast the month of Ramadan, and you do the hajj, the pilgrimage, if you are able to do that. And you cannot be a mu'min, you cannot be a believer until you do the articles of faith. Al-Imanu Billah, to believe in Allah, wa malaikati and his angels, wa kutubihi and his books, wa rusulihi, all his messengers, alayhi salatu wasalam, ended with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa rusulihi. واليوم الآخر, and the last day, والقدر خيره وشره, and the fate or the pre-decreed destination, the good and the bad. That is what it is. This is the pillars of Islam and the pillars of Iman. No, they believe in nullifiers of faith. If I believe in the whole Quran, and if I disbelieve in a single verse, I'm a kafir. If I believe in the whole Quran and only disbelieve in one single verse, I'm a kafir. If I believe in the whole Quran and I disbelieve in alif lam mim, I'm a kafir. To that extent, because Quran is intact. Came on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And anyone who believes in opposite to the Quran is a kafir, is out of the fold of Islam.
Why do they not believe the five pillars?
The problem is with them. They believe in something called nullifiers of faith. They believe, which is they believe in other prophet after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's what they believe. The Qadianis, they believe in a prophet after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they will say Jesus, peace be upon him, they said he died. And he came in the form of this scumbag Ghulam Ahmed. That's what they believe. All of these things they call nullifiers of faith. And anyone who believe in nullifiers of faith, they were established by the British. He himself, Ghulam Ahmed, the scumbag, he said it is not permissible for the Muslims. He said the jihad is withdrawn. There is no jihad anymore. The jihad is finished. It's finished. There is no jihad. Meaning you don't struggle against the oppressors. So when the India under the colonization of the British at that time, he said to the Muslims, don't resist. It's not allowed to resist. It's not allowed to resist the Goras, which is the white people. That's their masters.
Are they a sect of Islam?
Right? No.
Are they not believing?
No, they are not really. They are out of the fold of Islam.
So you believe exactly what Islam teaches, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him.
Exactly.
So exactly what you believe right now,
exactly.
Your belief system,
yes.
Is exactly what a proper Muslim needs to believe.
Yes, basically.
To get to heaven. And that includes the
salvation. Not to get, we ask Allah to get to heaven. It's not granted even.
What do you mean?
It's not guaranteed. No one enters Jannah except by the blessings of Allah and the mercy of Allah. Even the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of us, we enter Jannah through the mercy of Allah azza wa jal.
So you don't know if Muhammad even went to heaven?
No, we don't say we don't know. Allah azza wa jal promised all the Prophet and Messenger of Allah they're going to go. But he said about himself alayhi salatu wasalam, that he alayhi salatu wasalam, he said about himself, and I don't know what Allah is going to do to me. But Allah affirms in the Quran that all the Prophets and the Messenger of Allah, فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ, the Prophets of Allah, وَالصَّدِّقِينَ, the truthful people, وَالشُّهَدَاءَ and the martyrs, وَالصَّالِحِينَ, the pious people, those are going to be in the ranks, in the highest ranks of Jannah.
Okay, so two...